everybody, welcome to MMM Dance with Susan Jack. I am Susan Jack, and I'm very excited to be dancing with you yet again. So this is our third episode for our mature adult and senior class. If you haven't done episodes one or two yet, I strongly recommend going back to the very first one and working through, as this is a progressive dance technique that we are doing here. Just a quick reminder as well to always work within your own body. Nothing should ever hurt or should be uncomfortable for you. If something is hurting today, whether it's a knee, a hip, a shoulder, or something, please modify the movement or eliminate it altogether. Most importantly, breathe and just enjoy. Again, we still have all these crazy times happening right now. The world is changing daily as to restrictions, what we can and can't do. So most importantly, just be, just enjoy the movement. It's nice to kind of reconnect even just for a short while with each other. You will probably hear my dogs barking away in the background. They are upstairs right now, but who knows, they might come and join us if they are having their own separation anxiety issues. For that, I would say enjoy as well. Here we go. We're gonna start with a warm-up. So if you have a chair handy, we will use the chair, but then we'll also put it away to the side and then we'll come back to it again. So being careful in the space that you have around you, making sure just to move coffee tables, etc., out of the way, making sure that you are staying safe as well. All right, here we go with the warm-up. Okay, starting seated, we're gonna start working through your head, neck, and shoulders. First of all, just take a breath in, float the hands up and down, and circle your shoulders. Again, floating the hands up and down, and circle the shoulders. One more, letting go of all the tension you're feeling right now. Setting aside the worries, and just simply enjoy this next hour for you. And circle. Taking your head all the way over to the right, all the way over to the left, and again to the right. Just nice gentle breathing as you're doing this. Coming to center, tipping down to the right, ear to your shoulder, over to the left, and again to the right, and once more to the left. This time on the right, hold it here just for an extra moment. If you want more of a stretch, you can reach that right arm down. Oh, that feels nice. Good, and relax. Same thing to the other side, and stretch. Coming to center, tipping your chin and rolling down. Extending up, just a neutral. Again, tucking the chin in, rolling down nice and slow. And extending up. And staying here, just some shoulder circles, right and left. Some nice, gentle breathing. Slow. We're going to stay here with this next piece of music. Oh, no, we're not. I must be on my own. All right, staying right here. We're going to increase our shoulder circles. Right shoulder. Circle right and left. Right. Picking things up a bit. Coming forward, same thing. Circle. Feeling that stretch through your upper back. Okay, we're gonna do big circles, slower time. Circle and back. Circle and back. If that feels good, you can add the head looking back. Circle, stretching back. Coming forward, big circles. Again, if that feels good, you can add the head lifted. Last one here. stretching up, both hands stretch up, contract back, tight through your abdominals, stretching up. Good, add a shoulder circle, stretching our sides, right and left. Here we go, stretching up, over to the side, relax and stretch, and open. Same thing to the left, stretching up, and over, relax and stretch, and open. Again, stretching up, right arm comes down. We really want to stretch that left side, so stretch, reach to the upper oblique, and open. And again, stretching up. Now we're stretching through your right side, stretching up and open. Coming to center, excuse me, twisting right and center and left. So make sure you're staying nice and square in your chair, just twisting through your upper body and center. If this feels comfortable, add the head. Two more. Good. And relax. We're working through your hip flexors. Just lifting each foot. Right foot and left. Right and left. Right, left. So we're really working through here, sitting nice and tall. So lift up. Extend. And in and down. Same thing, left. Lift up. Extend out. In, we're adding in work for the quadriceps. Up, extend, in, and down. Up, extend. Now we're gonna add in for the foot. Up, extend, and flex. Point, flex, point, flex, point, flex, changing sides. Coming up, extend, flex, and point, flex. Good. Lifting the right foot, just working through rotations, wrist and ankle, and reverse that circle. Changing feet, circling one direction, and reversing that. Good. All right, we're gonna come to standing. We're gonna do a little bit more standing up right beside our chair. The chair is there if you need it for balance at all. You may also stay seated if you prefer that as well. So working through the foot. So pressing the ball of the foot to the floor, spreading through the toes. And press. Press. Good. 5, 6, 7. Rolling off the toe. So just using more of the foot muscles, working through the arch. It's a little faster tempo. We will slow it down. We're gonna come up a little higher. So roll and change, roll and change. Again, if you need the chair for balance or a counter, fireplace, mantle, whatever you handy. All right, we're gonna come up to the side of your leg. So shin or knee, you can be just to the shin, you can be all the way up to the knee, wherever you're comfortable. And if you want a bit more of a challenge, if your balance is steady, you can alternate the arm. So swing and relax. Swing and relax. In opposition. Do you remember that? We started opposition in episode 1. Good. Good. Hands to your hips, you're gonna wipe your feet back. Working through the quads still, but stretching through your hamstrings too. That's it, wiping your shoes off. Good. All right, next we're gonna work through your calf. So taking your right foot back behind you, pressing the heel to the floor. I'm just gonna go in the oblique so you can see what I'm doing. Heel to the floor, getting that stretch through your calf, stretching your arms up. Again, grabbing your chair if you need to. Good. Pressing up and pushing back.
Good. Pressing up and pushing back. And pressing back.
Changing sides, putting your other foot behind you, pressing that heel to the floor, stretching up. Good. And up.
Pressing back, feeling the stretch in the back of your leg. And again, press. Up.
Last one. Changing feet once more. Now we're going to work more through the quadricep. Heel to the floor first to start, hands on your hips. You're going to flex that knee, tuck the pelvis. Pushing back. Flex and tuck. So the heel is lifted on that back foot. Flex and tuck. Changing sides. Other foot back. I keep hitting my chair. Good. Flex and tuck. Pushing back. So heel to the floor. Heels lifted now and tuck. Press and tuck. Last one here. Press and come in. I'm going to just march your feet. Release the arms. Good. Feet are going to come apart. Toes are pointing out to the side. Hands are lifted. Flexing to the right knee to the right and left. Now we worked on alternate half knee bending, I think in episode one. Seems so long ago. Keeping the pelvis nice and square. Don't let yourself tip. No reaching here. Staying square. Good. I'm going to add on. So we've got right and left in the center. Release the arms and the legs. If you want a little lift on the toes, down to the left and the right. Release both knees. A gentle lift or stay flat-footed. You have two options. Again, right and left and center and lift. Wonderful. Just bring your feet in a nice big circle. Wonderful. We are all done with that for now. So we are going to take our chairs and tuck them to the side. We will come back to them later in the class though. So just out of the way for now. And we are going to start with our MMM work, our MMM exercises. So we're gonna start with walking variations. So in our last episode, we did breathing progression. This one here, do you remember it? We had our three levels where we're working through our lungs, expanding our lungs in different levels. We're going to combine that with some walking steps. So you still have your four counts to breathe in as you're walking. One, two, three, four, and four counts to breathe out as you continue walking. Five, six, seven, eight. We do that two times. So again, you're going to walk in the space that you have around your coffee table, wherever you are working right now. We're gonna work through two of each level. So you've got breathing in, two, three, four, five. Breathing out, twice. Breathing in, and breathing out, our second level. Walk, two, and three, four. Breath out, five, six, seven, eight. Walking, breathing in, breathing out. Our third level. Up, and open, and relax. Done two times, and up, and open, and relax. Now, if you don't have space, do just as I did. You walk right on the spot. That works as well. Okay, so with the music, in your space or on the spot, here we go. Ready, and breathe in. Two, three, four, and out. Again, breath in, breath out. Second level, up forward, nice and strong. Expand, keep breathing in. Now out. Again, up forward. Third level, do you remember it? All the way up. If it's good to have your head, let that follow the hands. Breath in. Pause just for a moment. Okay, part D. Who remembers? Those of you in my class, do you know? What am I saying right now? If you answered spider on my knee, you got it. other Emma members in the world are probably saying, what is she talking about? It's how we remember. Spider on my knee. Ah, get rid of it. Shoot away. Stamp, get rid of it. Hands come up to our circle position, palms to the ceiling, and they relax to, it's still there. Breathe in, two, three, four, and out, two, three, and four. It's funny what we do to remember these little things, isn't it? So you got parts A, B, and C, our normal breathing progression, and part D, Susan Jack's Spider Under Me. From the top with the music, here we go. Here we go. Breathing in. Breathing out. Again, breath in. Eyes are lifted, shoulders are down. Part two, arms forward. Stretching wide and relax. Breath out. Again. Breath in. Part three, all the way up to the ceiling. Breath in and open. Again, and up, open. Part D, spider on my knee, here we go. Breath in. You can emphasize that first step, breath out. Once more. Nicely done. Again, if you've really liked something, feel free to pause it anytime during this class, rewind, and do it again. You have that option. You can't do it in my class in person, but you can certainly do it here. Okay, so last class, we worked on our Greek position arms. Do you remember them? Yes? I'm going to give you a quick review just in case. So we had our arms relaxing and stretching to first position, and first, and second, and fourth. I'm gonna go in profile just with the same thing so you can make sure to see everything. So we've got first, and second. We drop and swing into our fourth position, like that, using your torso for your twist. Do you remember now? Okay, well today for the Greek positions, we're going to learn the legs. Now, legs are very intensive. It's a lot of strenuous work on the quadriceps, the hamstrings, your feet, and of course your knees. So if you need to modify any part of this for you for today, you do that, okay? I'm going to show you two different ways to do it. The first is the original way, the original Greek position legs. I'm going to work in profile again so you can see exactly what's happening. You've got a larger than normal step. If you're comfortable with it, you're up on both toes. You're flexing both knees in the center. Your weight's in the center. So I'm not in a lunge, and I'm not sitting back too far here. I want to be right in the middle. And we have a little pelvis tuck, and we hold that for six counts. Now, if you find you're wobbly at all, push down on your heels. That's going to help to anchor you. Transition to get to the next step. We're going to push off this front foot, lift up, legs are straight, stepping into the next one, and flexing. Tuck. We hold that. Again, if you're wobbly at all, push down on those heels. Okay, can you feel that? Did you try it? Try it with me. Let's do it together. Just nice and slow like that. A large step, up on the toes, flexing the knees, and hold it. Good, so with our regular MMM music, we hold this for six counts. That's a lot. Take that step into the next one, and sink and hold. Good, can you feel that? Are you wobbly a little bit? Contract, push down on those heels. Even though they're off the floor, they're still up and you're still pushing down. Option two. So if this is strenuous on your knees, sometimes it is for me, sometimes I certainly have to back off. You're gonna shorten your stride, stay flat-footed, and have a knee bend to where you're comfortable. So I shorten my stride. Normally in Greek position, I'm a little bit wider. I'm gonna shorten my stride a bit, flex both my knees comfortably. Again, trying to stay in between. You will feel a little bit more work in the back leg. Tuck the pelvis. And again, you hold that. To get to the next one, you simply rise up, step into the next one, and flex. Okay, so you always have choices for you. Now, with the music, we're gonna try this. We're just gonna hold these for four beats. So So maybe we'll do four and then we'll stop and we'll turn around and we'll do four more coming the other way. Does that work for you? Here we go. One, two, three, here we go. And one, two, hold, three, four. And one, two, three, four. And one, two, three, last one. And one, two, three. And just changing, going the opposite direction. I'm going to do option two, shorten stride, flexing knees, four, one, two, three, head stays forward, I'm just checking on you, one, two, three, and four, last one, two, three, and four, good, rest for just a moment. Great, we are going to do it just one more time. Now, really important, we're going to add in that breathing, our MMM breathing. So we're going to breathe in for two beats and out for two beats. A little bit more of a strong pelvic contraction when you're breathing out, okay? Strong. Ready? Three, four, five, six. Adding in that breathing. Here we go. And one, breathe in. Breathe out, tuck. Contract, contract. And one, two. Two more. One, two. Last one here. Good, just rest. Changing directions wherever you are. We'll do just four more. Breath out here. Ready, and go. Up, one, two, breathe out. And one, two, out. Last one. Good, rest just for a moment. So next week we're actually gonna add in everything together. Arms, legs, body, breathing. First and second, maybe fourth Greek position. So you have to come back for episode four, right? Perfect. All right, staying right where you are, we're gonna do a breathing exercise called pelvic tilting. So in this one, when we're breathing out, it's really important that your knees are released so we can actually do work through the pelvis, and that's gonna help us to increase our breath out. So we start with our breath in, our arms open to second, and on our breath out, hands come to the hips, release your knees, tuck your pelvis, strong contraction. I'm just gonna go in profile so you can see. Breathing in, breathing out, tuck. Okay, again, breathing in, and out. Okay, so with all deep breathing for our exercises, for specifically for breathing, if you find that you're getting dizzy, back off just a little bit on your breathing. You may also put a little space in between your feet so they're right in line with your hips, okay? So again, always working within your own body, and it changes from day to day, so being aware of that as well. Should we try it with music? Here we go. Good, just a gentle breath out. No tension. Here we go. Breathing in. Breath out. Release those knees. Again, breathing in. Breathing out. And again, breath in. Breath out. Last one. Profile so you can see. Breath in. Breath out. Good. Stop right there. So when we've talked about this one in our class, we've also talked about doing this one lying down on the floor. Another option is doing it standing against the wall, so you can really work on pressing the small of your back to the floor or to the wall. So I'm going to show you lying down first. I'm going to show you an option standing up as well against a wall, and it's something for you to work on. Since we're not in class, you might feel comfortable getting down on your own floor in your house, so certainly give that a try. So on the floor, let's move back a bit so we can see. So your knees are relaxed in our crook lying position. You still breathe out, opening to second. On your breath out, hands to your hips, belly button to your spine, spine to the floor. You're still doing that pelvic tilt. A breath in, a breath out, pelvic tilt, small your back to the floor, belly button to your spine. If I was to stand up and do this against the wall, so if I'm against the wall, same thing, your feet are just a little bit further apart so that you can bend your knees. You have your breath in, on your breath out, release your knees. You're really working to press the small of your back against the floor, against the wall. Knees extend, breathing in. Breathing out, release your knees. Okay, so nice and relaxed, a breath out. Ready? Here we are, wherever you are. Breathing in, breath out, pressing the back down. Abdominals nice and tight, pelvis is tilted. Breath in, release your pelvis. Breath out. Again. Breath in. Breath out. Just a couple more. Breath in. Last one here. Breath in. How is that? Deep breathing is so nice. It just helps to center us. It helps to filter our lungs. It's very good for you. Okay, moving on. We are going to jump into yellow first arm exercise. So in our episode one, we did basic arm exercise. We added some leg movements onto that with white arm exercise last episode. And today we're jumping to the third level, to yellow, to do first arm exercise. So in this exercise, it's really important that your arms are nice and relaxed and supple, and you have this rippling movement that goes from your shoulders, actually from your shoulder blades, I'll turn around, from your shoulder blades, right through your arms, extending through your fingertips. So contracting between your shoulder blades, relax and stretch down to your second position. Contracting your shoulder blades, relax and stretch to first. Again for second variation, keeping your shoulders down, careful not to lift them. And then we just close and rest in our diamond position. We repeat that coming down. Relax and stretch. Relax and stretch. Relax and stretch. And close. So that's A. With B, we're going to add in a gentle knee bend. Now, if you are very flexible in your knees and you have no problems doing knee bends, Pam, I can see you right now, you're going to say yes, I'm going all the way down. If you want to go right down to the floor, you may with your knee bend, but your heels must be lifted and you sink to wherever you're comfortable. That's not comfortable for me, so I'm going to keep my feet flat to the floor and I'm just going to have a gentle knee bend. So in profile, you can see I'm just releasing my knees in a gentle knee bend, but if you want to go any deeper than that, heels are off and then you go wherever you're comfortable. You can go right down to sit on your feet if you wish. Again, always options. So we do that. We rise first. If you're going all the way down, staying flat-footed, releasing your knees to where you're comfortable, into the diamond position, coming back up. One, two. At your second position, you have just a gentle lift. Now, if you're lifted, you close your feet. We do the same thing in an open position, so feet are turned out to the side. We rise first. If we're staying flat-footed, we stay here and we just have a gentle knee bend. If your heels are off and you want to keep going, away you go. Three and four. Up. One, two, a gentle rise. Three and four, close your feet. Next, we go on to part three. To C, we have single arms working. So we relax and stretch right, and we're going to leave that arm there. Then the left arm works. Now it stays. The right arm works again to our first position. Then the left arm. And it's going to go like this all the way up to our diamond position. Right and the left. We're going to come down exactly the same way. The right arm leads, stretching up to the second variation position. And the left. First position. And the left. Second position. And the left. And we close again with the left. Now part D, exactly the same as C, but we're adding a slight hip movement. This hip movement is from our spinal mobility. We have the lateral pushes right and left. So we've got to the right. It's very small, it's very subtle. Right and left, right, left, close, right and left. Coming down exactly the same. And you can see my head is following each arm movement here. If that's comfortable for you. If this is brand new for you, I always say, start with the feet and the body, add in the arms, then the head. Breathing, of course, you can do that right from the beginning. Shall we go with the music? Breath out. Breath in. And out. Here we go. Breathing in. And out. Do this two times. If you can challenge yourself to breathe over eight, you may do that. Now breathing out. With the knee bent, rising up first, gentle knee bend, or to the floor if you're comfortable with that. Extending up to a gentle lift. Same thing, open position. Rising up, and two, and close, and up, two, extending up on the toes, and close, single hands, right first, and two, three, so finishing each movement right to the fingertips, closing right, good, coming down on the right side, one, breath in, same thing. Breathing in. Good. How was that? Can you feel that in your arms and your shoulders a little bit? It's a lot different from our basic arm exercise. You're working different muscles, but it's really pretty, having that nice smooth motion. Right, I'm not going to repeat that one with the music, but you can certainly do that if you'd like to do it over again. It is very arm intensive, and we have sitting coordination coming up. So grab your chairs, and meet me back here in just 1 minute. Do you have your chairs? Are you sitting nice and comfortably? You have enough room to move? So for those of us that did episode one, you learned sitting coordination, or it was review from you, for you if you're in my classes. So just to review the exercise first, and then we'll do it all together with music. Now, for us, we don't add the spin right and left. So if you have this space at home and you can do that, please feel free to do that. We stay facing forward. If you want, you may add the half turns for each movement, okay? So again, working in your own space. I'm doing what we're used to doing in our class. So we start with the introduction. You've got clap on your lap, lifting right, left, clap, and second. First, we're going to do ankle and wrist flexion. So clap, extend, point, flex. Same thing, other side. Point, flex. Clap, sliding forward. Ankle and wrist flexion. Right, left, right. Left, clap, sliding back. Tippy toes. Right, left, right, left. Repeating the introduction. For our class, we switch this up and do the left leg first, two, clap, and second. Now we're gonna do elbow and knee flexion. So clap, extend, flex, stretch, flex, stretch, making sure you're getting a nice big twist. Clap, extend, flex, stretch, flex, stretch. Clap, sliding everything forward. Now you're doing rotations through your ankle and ankles and wrists. So right over left, left over right, clap, slide back, left this time, and right. Last, we have wrist and ankle circles, rotations. Here, we circle one and two. Clap, extend, circle one and two. From here, the right hand comes up. Flex one, flex left, two and three, four. Pushing down right, pushing down left, lift and push, lift and push. A big dramatic circle with the music. Next, we're working through the shoulder joint, swinging and circles. So we've got clap, extend, nothing with the leg this time, just swinging with the arm. One, two, three, four. Again, if you wanted to add a twist and turn, you may certainly do that. Clap. This time we have circles, so underhand fist, circle one, circle two. One, and stretch. Circle one, and two. Now we have this stretch movement and a little bit of twisting through our spine. The feet extend, stretching up, relaxing forward, being tight through your abdominals. The right foot comes back, the hands come twisting to the right. We bring the left foot back, twisting left. Sitting up, but the hands are low, twisting right, twisting left. Now in the air, right and left. We repeat that. Stretching, contracting forward. The left foot comes back this time, twisting left and right. Sitting up, twisting left, right in the air, left and right. Big dramatic circle again with the music. Our final step is our basic arm exercise with leg movements and head movements. Oh my goodness, it's a lot. So again, start with the arms, add in the legs when they get comfortable. So you've got one, extend two, cross, head lifts three and four. Don't forget to breathe. Breathe in, breathe in, breathe out, breathe out. We do that four times. And then to finish, we have a diamond, pushing right, pushing left, a big dramatic circle last time with the music, clap and finish in our second position. It's a lot. So for the people that are in my class, my students, you know this exercise. You should have been saying, just hit twice and we've got this. But for those that are new to this exercise, I wanted to review it. Please feel free to stop and go through slowly on your own if you need to. Now, with music, here we go. Ready? Up and down. Lift, right, left, up and second. Wrist and ankle, point and flex. Point, flex, point, flex. Other side, good. Point, flex, point, flex. Slide your feet forward, flex. Right, left, come back. Plantar flexion, right, left. Back to the introduction. This time with left, one, two, up, and second. We have knee and elbow flexion. Flex, stretch, same thing. To the left, flex, stretch, slide your feet forward, working through those ankles, right and left, come back, left this time, one, two, now we have wrist and ankle circles, circle one, you can add the head if you wish, stretch back, circle one and two, right arm up, right, left, flex, point, push down right and left. Lift and push, big circle. Next, working through that shoulder joint, swinging. Clap, stretch back, swing. One, two, three, four. Same thing. One, two. Now circles. With a fist, circle one and two. Same thing. One, two, big stretch. Lift, forward. Back right, back left, twisting right, in the air. Again, stretch, and forward, back left.
there. Big circle. Good diamond arm exercise. Lift, stretch, cross, and down. Lift, stretch, cross, and down. Again, lift, extend, up, down. Last one. Good, you've got it. Diamond, press right, press left, big circle. Good. Ta-da, you did it. Well done. All right, staying right on your chairs, we're going to jump to the white level and we're going to do thoracic twisting. So this one really works through your trunk rotators, through your twisters, with keeping your pelvis nice and still. Our arms are coming into our arms, similar to spinal mobility, and we're twisting right and left. So we're twisting to the right, straight through to the left, right and left, back to the right, because that's the side we started on, to our first position, and we come down to second. We go right away to the left-hand side. Left, two, three, four, breath in, and down. Oh, I gave it away before I could ask you what the breathing is. Breathing out on these two, three, four, breath in. Good, and then to the left. One, two, three, four, breath in and relax. Good, that's A. So, important that our head stays forward the whole time. We're not looking with the hands. So staying forward, 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 still stay forward, and you can gently lower with your hands in a second position, and then going right again to the left. So just A with the music, here we go. So our tempo is twisting one, two, three, relax and stretch, and down. Here we go. And one, two, three, four, in, and first. Again. One, two, three, four, left this time. Good. Again. Breathing out. Two, three, four, breathing in. To the left. Do you remember B? One, two, three, four. Drop, finish to the right. That's the side you started on. Right to the left. Two, three, four. Drop, up. Good breath. Oh, I was trying to trick you to see if you remembered for my students. All right, so I threw that in there at the last little bit just to see if you are still with me. So part two is very similar. We do right, left, stay there, drop those hands, come up, change your twist, and finish on the side you started. We started to the right first. Now we go to the left. Left, two, three, four, drop your arms, come up, change your twist, and finish facing left. Okay, one more time. We'll do 2A and 2B. There's no C. There's no more surprises. Here we go. Breath in. Breath out. One, two, three, four. Breath in. Ready? 2A. One, two, three, four. Breath in. To the left, same thing. One, two. We're back to the beginning. Breath in. Adding in B. Here we go. One, two, three. Stay here. Drop, change your twist, and down. Again, to the left. One, two, three, four. Drop. Finish on the left. Good job. All right, now those that would like to try, we're going to do exactly what we just did, but we're going to do it standing up. If you wish to stay seated, you can certainly do that. I'm just going to move my chair over for a bit here. If you're standing up, your feet are just a little bit further than shoulder apart. I'm going to stay facing you so you can see what I'm doing. But if you're doing this at home and you want to check yourself, you can stand perpendicular to a mirror and you can be checking your twist here. What's really important when I'm doing this standing up is that I'm not letting my hips go. This is all thoracic
twisting. It's all up in your thorax and your upper body. Okay, we're working through those core muscles. So my hips stay nice and neutral, which is again a reason why I'm gonna stay facing forward. So you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, first down to a second. The exercise is exactly the same. Shall we try it? Here we go. Two A and two B. Feet adjust, a little wider than standing stride. Breath out, breath in. Ready, here we go. Breath out, 1, 2, 3, 4. First, breath in. To the left, same thing. 1, 2, 3, 4. Breath in, and slide down with a second. B, 1, 2, 3. Drop here, head stays straight. To the left, 1, 2, 3. Keep your head forward, up and down. Good, nicely done. Okay, before we get rid of the chairs altogether, we are gonna do a balance. So last week we worked on elementary balance. Do you remember the trick for elementary? And easy, the difference? Elementary, school table, your hands are on the desk. So we're working through the easy balance and progressive balance. So we're gonna start seated and we're gonna finish standing up. So with our progressive balance, everything is in right angles. We're working through our fourth position. So you've got fourth position arms, nothing for the legs right now, 1, 2. Extend 3, 4, and relax all the tension out with your breath out. Do that 2 times. Breathing in, stretching long and lifting. That's gonna help you for the balance when we're standing. We do the same things with your legs. Lift and extend and relax, breath out. And repeat that with the left foot. And extend and out. Good. Standing up, we'll stand up quicker with the music, but just coming to beside your chair so you can use it if you need it for balance. Arms only. So you've got 1, extend and relax. And 1, and extend and relax. We do the same thing with your foot that we were doing last week with our balance, staying connected with the ground. So foot to the instep first, sliding forward, staying connected with the ground. Even that's working balance, I'm wobbling. And relax, breathing out. Same thing with the left, foot to the instep, extending and relax. Coming up a little bit higher if you wish, 2 options. You can stay here for the full balance, or you can leave 1 hand connected to your chair, extend and lower. I'm just gonna go and profile this way so I'm not kicking the chair. When I'm doing this, if you're comfortable with balance, you wanna lift your leg, your toe is pointing to the floor. We're not touching to the leg like we did with our easy, our elementary balance. So you're open, and if you're comfortable going higher, as long as your foot is pointing to the floor, okay? So we'll do that with the music. You ready? I might add in a little bonus. Pay attention. Arms only. Here we go. Breathing in. Breathing out. Once more like that. Breath in. Breath out. Adding in the legs. Breath in. Extend. Breath out. Same thing with the left. Breath in. Breath out. Here's where we're gonna add something. Just coming to standing. Breathing in. 2. Breathing out, sitting down. Reach for your chair if needed. Once more. Breath in. And relaxing, stepping beside your chair. Arms only. Breath in. Stretch wide. Lift the chest, nice and tall. Breath out. Again like that. Breath in. Breath out. Foot to the floor. Extending long. Breath out. Same thing with the left. Extending. Breath out. Now you can add more of a balance if you wish. Lifting up. Extending forward.
breath out. Last one here. Extend. And relax. Good.
How did you find the balance on the carpet? I'm working in carpet, so you might have a different floor surface, or you might be working in bare feet instead of shoes like we normally do in our class. How do you find it? It changes the whole dynamic, right? So I'm struggling here. Carpet is really hard to balance on. So as I say in my class, if you ever see me fall over, that's not part of it. Don't copy that. All right, we're gonna do one more exercise staying with our chair. And we're gonna do leg swinging balance. So this is working through the hip joint for mobility, circulation, just helping to get everything moving in your legs. So using the chair for balance if you need to. If not, your hands will be in second position when we're working. We start by swinging your right leg forward, and you're gonna hold it. So wherever you go, I'm gonna use the chair, I'm a little wobbly. Wherever you go, that's where you hold it. So if it's hard work for your quadricep, you can stay connected with the ground. You can come up a little higher or higher, but you have to hold it. We're gonna go back, brushing through the floor, doing the same thing. Then we're gonna do three quick and close. One, two, three, and close. When I close my feet, I'm also gonna close my hands. We do the same thing with the left foot. Forward and hold. Back and hold, three quick, and one, two, and three, and close. Going backwards with the right foot. Breathing in, out on the quick ones. Same thing with the left foot. Breath in, and out. One, and two, and three, and close. Okay, again, for me, working on carpet is a little bit challenging. My feet are sticking, but you really wanna work through the floor. If you brush the floor as you're going through, you're going to get more power in that joint itself, more work, okay? So mobilizing the hips a little bit, working through that joint. Slow breath in on these help position. Your breath out is going to help for the swing to get more movement there. With the music, here we go. Five, six, right leg. Here we go. Breathing in. And out. Quick. One, two, three, and close. Left, same thing. And quick. To the back. One, two, and three. And quick. One, two, three, and close. To the left. And four. And quick. One, two, three, right again, forward, and quick, one, left forward, breathing in, and quick, good, to the back with the right, last time with the left. And quick. Good, and relax. Wonderful, we're almost done. We're gonna put our chairs away and we're gonna do one final breathing sequence. It's one that we do in class. This is our third episode, so I thought instead of a little tiny sequence today, we'll do our breathing sequence, just helping to bring us back home and together. So chairs away for now. So this breathing sequence uses all of our breathing exercises from the first four colors. Well, maybe not all of them, but some of them from the first four colors, from basic, from white, from yellow, and from orange. So just follow along. You're gonna see easy breathing. You're gonna see white breathing A. You're gonna see alternate lung breathing, breathing progression, yellow neck rest breathing, upper and lower thoracic breathing A from orange, and the same with change of weight breathing from orange as well. You ready? Do some breathing with me. Here we go. All right, starting with white breathing, nice and relaxed, breathing in.
Wide in the night sky, are the lights hung?
Up through your center.
Why is the earth moving round the sun?
Breathing progression.
Floating in the vacuum.
Second level. Yellow neck rest breathing. Here we go.
Thoracic breathing from orange.
In the city only for a while. Here to face the fortune and the guile.
Change your weight breathing, right arm working.
I heard you on the radio. I couldn't help but smile. In the city only.
Good. Nice.
job. Same thing, other side, tucking forward, tucking back. Wonderful. Stretching your right hip to the wall, pushing your hip out, getting that stretch to the side. We're going to add in a side stretch all the way to the ceiling, stretching up. Same thing, other side. Pushing your left hip to the wall, feeling that stretch in your hip joint. We're adding in more of a side stretch all the way up. Good, wonderful. Back to center. Take a breath in. And a breath out. Roll your shoulders up and down. And again, a breath in. And a breath out. And shoulder roll. Last one here. Just before it's time to go, I just want to thank you for welcoming me into your homes once again. Thank you to my chief film director, editor, cinematographer, I guess is her name, titled Miss Julia Jack. She's been truly wonderful. If you find yourself anxious or just, it's hard, these times are hard right now, just take a quiet moment. Breathe deeply. Remember your M&M breathing. In through the nose, out through the mouth. Find a quiet corner, maybe a quiet patio outside your door. Just breathe. Connect outside with nature. Call a friend. Call me. I'm always here for you guys. And just remember that you're not alone. Even though you might feel alone, you're not alone. We're here. We're with you. Anytime you need. Hit play, I'll be in your living room with you. And make sure that you take care of you. It's very important. Commit to taking care of you. I hope to see you back here for episode 4. Until then, be healthy, be safe, and take care.